So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247 where we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and NABARD. So let's begin with the session guys, but before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information regarding the daily sessions and also about the courses. So let's begin with the very first question, which is about the ACCR portal and Ayush Sanjeevani app. So you have to consider the following statements regarding this portal ACCR and Ayush Sanjeevani app, and you have to identify the correct statements. So let's talk about these portals and this portal and this app. So remember, Ayush Ministry has launched Ayush Clinical Case Repository Portal, which in short is ACCR portal, and the third version of Ayush Sanjeevani app. Remember, this Ayush Sanjeevani app is not a newly launched app, it is the third version. Iske pehle wale do version pichle saal launch ho chuke hain. Last year there two versions, its two versions were launched. Okay, and talking about the portal, so remember, this portal guys will serve as a platform to support both Ayush practitioners and also the general public. It will help in collecting data on how the Ayush practitioners have actually responded to the COVID-19 pandemic. इसमें हमें ये डेटा मिलेगा कि जो आयुष प्रैक्टिशनर्स हैं, आयुष के डॉक्टर्स हैं, उन्होंने किस तरीके से कोविड पैंडेमिक में रिस्पॉन्ड दिया है. ओके, एंड इट विल ऑल्सो डॉक्यूमेंट द स्ट्रेंथ्स ऑफ आयुष सिस्टम्स फॉर ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ वेरियस डिजीज कंडीशंस, बेसिकली रिलेटेड टू आयुष. आयुष के लिए आयुष जो है वो किस तरीके से डिजीजेस को खत्म करने में हेल्प करता है, उससे रिलेटेड सारा डेटा कलेक्ट किया जाएगा इन दिस पोर्टल. एंड टॉकिंग अबाउट द ऐप, सो रिमेंबर द ऐप इंटेंड्स टू जनरेट डेटा ऑन यूसेज ऑफ आयुष एंड इट्स मेजर्स अमंग द पॉपुलेशन एंड इट्स इंपैक्ट इन द प्रिवेंशन ऑफ कोविड-19. एंड द डेटा कलेक्टेड थ्रू दिस ऐप गाइस विल बी एनालाइज्ड टू फाइंड आउट द यूसेज ऑफ आयुष इंटरवेंशंस एंड इट्स एफिकेसी. आयुष का क्या एफिकेसी है, क्या एफिशिएंसी है, उसका पता लगाया जाएगा थ्रू द डेटा कलेक्शन. And remember one thing also, that this data collection from the app will also help in boosting the research in the Ayush sector and specifically for the various medicines of Ayush like Ayush 64, Kabasur, Kudaneer, etc. So these are some information about this portal and this app. And now let's come back to the question. You have to identify the correct statement. The portal will help in collection of data regarding support provided by Ayush in COVID-19. This is absolutely correct. The app generates data on usage of Ayush measures in the country. This is also correct. कितना जो हमारे देश के लोग हैं वो आयुष का इस्तेमाल कर रहे हैं. And it is the fourth version of Ayush Sanjeevani app. No, that is not the fourth version. That's third version. ये कैसा version है? Third version है. So this statement is incorrect. So therefore, guys, the correct answer should be what? Option B, only 1 and 2, because we have to identify the correct statements. All right. And now let's move ahead to question number 2, which says, how much additional amount will be provided by central government to states for providing monetary assistance to 11.8 crore students under the midday meal scheme? Midday meal scheme ke andar government kitna additional amount provide karayegi states ko taki 11.8 crore students ko financial assistance, monetary assistance provide karaya ja sake under the midday meal scheme. And question number 3 is also based on the scheme. Now let's talk about what is the news regarding midday meal scheme. So remember, Minister of Education, who is Dr. Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank, has approved the monetary assistance to 11.8 crore students through direct benefit transfer for cooking cost component of the midday meal scheme. And this is of course has been done to safeguard the nutritional interests of the children, thereby protecting their immunity. क्योंकि हमें पता है कि कोविड में सबसे ज्यादा जो रोल है वो किसका होता है, इम्यूनिटी का होता है. तो स्टूडेंट्स की इम्यूनिटी को ध्यान में रखते हुए गवर्नमेंट ने ये एडिशनल मॉनेटरी असिस्टेंस प्रोवाइड कराया है अंडर द midday meal scheme. And ye jo additional amount hai kitna hai, ₹1200 crores. The additional amount is how much? ₹1200 crores that will be provided to the states and UTs for the purpose. Now talking about the scheme, ab hame scheme ke bare mein bhi baat kar leni chahiye, because agar zikr hai iska to it can be asked in your exam. So its objective is to improve the nutritional level among children and thereby enhancing the enrollment, retention and attendance of children in school. जो स्टूडेंट्स हैं उनका न्यूट्रिशनल लेवल को इंक्रीज करना, इंप्रूव करना, और उसी के साथ साथ स्कूल के अंदर एनरोलमेंट इंश्योर करना, अच्छा रिटेंशन और अटेंडेंस. ओके, इट वाज लॉन्च इन द ईयर 1995 एज द नेशनल प्रोग्राम ऑफ न्यूट्रिशनल सपोर्ट टू प्राइमरी एजुकेशन But remember, in the year 2004, it was rechristened as the midday meal scheme. 2004 में ये relaunch हुआ था, rechristened हुआ था as midday meal scheme. And ministry, it is implemented by the Ministry of Education. Remember this. This is very important fact because the ministry can be confused with the Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution. But don't get confused. The ministry is the Ministry of Education. Now, what about the coverage? So, all children from classes 1st to 8th who are enrolled in government schools, government aided schools, local body schools, special training centers, madrasas and maktabs, which are supported by Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan. So, all these students are covered under midday meal scheme. And talking about the funding, so it is a centrally sponsored scheme, and we all know centrally sponsored scheme is that where center or state ka kuch na kuch ratio hota hai, where there is a certain ratio of funding between center and states, and here in this scheme it is 60-40, 60% by the central government and 40% by the state governments. All right, now what about the calories intake? So energy, it says that for the primary students the minimum energy intake required is 450 calories, while for upper primary it is 700 calories. Talking about the proteins, for primary it is 12 grams, while for upper primary it is 20 grams. Okay, and this guys is the food grains intake. Food grain 100 gram hai for primary classes, and this is for upper primary 150 grams, pulses 20 grams, 30 grams respectively for primary and upper primary. Vegetables 50 grams and 75 grams, and oils and fats 5 grams and 7.5 grams. So you can take a screenshot of this. These are the nutritional requirements as per the midday meal schemes. Okay, so this was about this news, and now let's come back to question number 2 and 3. So here the question is how much additional amount. So it is guys how much rupees 1200 crore. Option D will be the correct answer. 1200 crores will be provided by the central government to the states or UTs for providing monetary assistance to the students under midday meal scheme. And you have to consider the following statements regarding midday meal scheme and identify the incorrect statement. So midday meal scheme ka question काफी times RBI में या NABARD में नहीं पूछा गया है. So we can expect this question guys. Remember, incorrect statement identify करना. It was launched in 1995. This is absolutely correct. The implementing ministry is Ministry of Food, Consumer Affairs and Public Distribution. So as I told you, don't get confused between these two ministries. This is incorrect. The correct ministry is the Ministry of Education. It is a 100% centrally sponsored scheme. No, it is 60-40. The ratio is how much? 60-40. All children from classes 1st to 8th are provided support under the scheme. This is absolutely correct. And Uttar Pradesh was the first state to implement the scheme. No. Remember guys, let me give you one more information here. It's Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu was the first state to implement the scheme. Alright. Which means this statement is also incorrect. So we have second, third and fifth statement which are incorrect. Therefore, the correct answer should be what? Option D, only 2, 3 and 5. And now let's move ahead to question number 4, which is the last question for this session. Which of the following statements regarding provision related to migrant workers in India is are incorrect? Now we are discussing about migrant workers. So there should be some news, there must be some news regarding migrant workers or the unorganized workers. So let's talk about this. So the news is that recently the Supreme Court of India has directed the central government and state governments to complete the registration of unorganized worker. Pichle saal jab COVID hua tha, us time unorganized workers ki registration start ki gayi thi from the last year. Since COVID, jab se aaya hai tab se. Unorganized workers ki registration start ki gayi thi, and Supreme Court of India has directed the central government and the state governments to complete the registration of these unorganized workers as soon as possible. And remember, of course, the main objective of this direction is that the unorganized workers can avail the benefits of welfare scheme, taki jo unorganized workers hai unko bhi jo welfare schemes hai uska benefit diya ja sake. And these are guys some of the key highlights of the observations by Supreme Court. Like they said that Supreme Court has asked states to keep a record of returning migrant laborers with details about their skills, so that according to their skill the job can be provided to them. Then Supreme Court has said that there should be a collaboration between states and center in creating national database of unorganized workers. There should be a suitable mechanism which can ensure the delivery of benefits of welfare scheme. And also the stranded migrant workers should be provided with dry ration under any suitable scheme. Like Atmanirbhar Bharat ke andar de do, Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Yojana ke andar de do, Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Anna Yojana ke andar de do, kisi bhi scheme ke andar jo stranded migrant workers hai unko ration provide karana zaruri hai, and the ration should be dry. Okay. Now these are some other provisions, guys, which are related to the migrant workers. Like we have Section 21 of Code on Occupational Health, Safety and Working Condition, which says that there is a need to maintain a database of migrant workers for skill mapping and utilizing government scheme efficiently. Then we have Section 112 of Social Security Code 2020, which says that there is a need of registration of unorganized workers, gig workers and platform workers. And remember, all the establishment which are hiring interstate migrants should be registered, and all the contractors should be licensed under Interstate Migrant Workmen Act of 1979. So you should remember these acts and these sections, because you can use these acts and sections in your essay part and in any of the answer. Okay. So this was about this news, and now let's come back to the question. You have to identify the incorrect statement regarding provisions related to migrant workers. So statement number one is, a database of migrant workers is being constructed under Section 112 of Code on Occupational Health, Safety and Working Condition. That is not Section 112, that's Section 21. Then we have Section 112 of Social Security Code 2020 provides for registration of unorganized workers, gig workers and platform workers. This is absolutely correct. One second. Yes. And all establishment hiring interstate migrants should be registered under Interstate Migrant Workmen Act of 1979. This is also correct. I was confused between Section 21 and 112. So, isliye maine usko confirm kiya ek bar. So, this is correct. Section 21 hai, Code on Occupational Health, Safety and Working Condition ka. And then we have Section 112 of Social Security Code 2020. So, here we have only two statements which are correct here. But we have to identify incorrect statement. Alright. So, option C, only one will be the correct answer. Alright. And guys, that's it for the session today. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Milte hain Wednesday ke session mein. Goodbye, take care and God bless.